there has been no test because there is no use practicing something you cannot miss. This is what you call a one-shot deal, and I'm not coming back for any late show, honey. I'm going to do it one time.
Live fast, die young, and be a good-looking corpse.
Live fast, die young, and be a good-looking corpse. Right. Well, it depends on how you look at life after death. If a guy thinks his soul transfers to the beyond in the same form and shape that he might be when he dies, who the hell would want to live to be 90? Always admired the Jewish people for the business sense.
Thank you. and out of consciousness, the horrible weight of the airplane buried at the back of my head, dead squirrel in my mouth, sticking up the joint. I took a look around, everyone dead, all those buildings abandoned, took a lot out of me, the debris. Yeah, now I worked it, chewed off my legs. It sounded like that, the car alarm. People leaned out their windows, checked out the scene. The fat cop had diarrhea, the fat cop had died. I said, the fat cop had died. I said, the fat cop had diarrhea. People leaned out, I said. We'll be right back.
big, big pool of rocks and stuff in the room. Buried all the windows in concrete. It would be cool if you just disappeared. I love you, but I'd really like to put a knife in your head. This whole thing with the meatball and stuff, that's all shit. I don't know shit. All the planets are out of alignment. Misaligned. I stagger. Pretty often. I'm a write-off. Sometimes I'm into this romantic kind of notion. Dumb.
yourself a cheap pair. You gotta get yourself a cheap pair of plastic sunglasses, or a really cheap pair of plastic wraparounds. You get them just down the street. It's $4 for the pair. You should stock up. You should buy 3 or 4 pairs. Really, no one ever fucks with you. You put them on. No one fucks with you. And they're cheap. It's better than a... better than a wig. Or a really stupid haircut. Or a nose ring. You get afraid on the bus, and you ever get... ever get scared on the bus?
Oh, Skin. Documentary, but it'd be like sort of a time life thing. Different ways of brain modification, and it'd be the computer simulating all different ways of feeling when you're on like different drugs,
different kinds of meditation, sex, anything, man. Think of it. It'd be like, have you read Understanding Comics?
Ever read what?
That book, Understanding Comics.
No.
You should read it. It's really good. I'll lend it to you if you need a copy.
Okay.
I don't know. I was getting off thoughts. And the other thing I wanted to ask you about. You originally, when I met you, you weren't smoking dope because you used to get the fear, right?
Yeah.
Can you tell me about it?
The fear. I don't know, it's a hard thing to describe. It's like
it's just overwhelming and you just can't get control?
Yeah, well, it's like it's overwhelming anxiety, right? And it's like,
and you can't combat it?
Yeah, and the thing is, for me, I think it's real personal for everyone, like what level it takes. For me, it always takes a thing, like it's always a control thing, like having to control, because really, I guess it's just intensity, right? You know, it's just like unfamiliar intensity, right? You know, which is why I had to quit pot, because you know, you're getting high and you just want to feel the same way you always do, and all of a sudden you're smoking joint, and it's this, you know what I mean, this whole, so it's an uncontrolled intensity thing, and then like, I don't know, yeah, it's just like your body goes into, gets pumped full of adrenaline, right, and your heart starts going ka-chunk.
Well, I'll tell you something, here's a good thought, this has happened to me 3 times recently. It never used to happen to me, I never ever feel like sick or anything, like, you know, like, so what you talk about, I'll be sitting there, I'll be wow, you know, because I don't smoke unless maybe it's like once a week, you know, so trying to take some feel like tolerance again.
Yeah.
And then I'll smoke and I'll be sitting there and I'll be like, you know, wow, I'm really high. All of a sudden I'll sort of slip into it, you know, and I'll be like, but I'm able to fight it. Like that night on mushrooms I told you about, I just couldn't fight it. I surrendered myself to this mind fuck.
Yeah.
But you know, when I'm on pot, it's like I feel strong enough, so I go, no, fuck it. I go like, so I try to force myself to see it in a different way. I try to see it as, I don't get this high that often, so it's like a whole new way of seeing the world, so fuck, I might as well dig it, you know, instead of being afraid of it, and that it works.
Yeah.
And it's like, yeah, this happened to me 3 times, it happened to me tonight again, you know. That's why I just walk around, I want to get an ice cream. I saw my sister's friend.
Break my word. of my room. Thirteen angels falling. Laughing at the holes in me. Pissing through the shit at the window. Fuck this song.
Experience in my life. I guess at 43 I'm still wondering because for so many years I was in a drug-induced coma, I think.
Yeah, well, I mean, I'm not going to write off your history that easily. You know?
I love you. I'm glad you're okay. Have you talked to Father John?
No, no, I haven't spoken to him in a couple months.
Thank you. last of his lifelong venture. Again he hesitated. And he put it down.
He stink like I stink. And hell, I stink a lot. We dress like shit. We don't need it.